and seeing the Eagle ready to soar, but Coppin stays sloppy with the ball early on. The Aggies knock it away, and the Aggies' Dana Elliott comes out with it, takes it all the way down for the layup, and North Carolina A&T was up by six. But Reggie Isaac got hot for the Eagles. He had 14 points tonight, pulls up for the jumper there to tie the score at 39. He had 12 points in the second half for Isaac. 3:30 left to play. The Aggies up by one, and Jarrett Orleff wide open, buries the three, giving Coppin State then the lead for good down the stretch. You see the sadness and then the celebration. Coppin State on its way to the NCAAs despite a losing record this season. The ship was decided, showtime. Robert Morris on the run, Andre Boyd, great long bounce pass to Moses Moss for the layup, and Monmouth Wayne goes deep in concentration. The Hawks then answer back. Alex Blackwell drives, spins, scores in traffic, and it was a two-point game at halftime. Now in the second half, Monmouth continued to go inside to Alex Blackwell, baseline, and scores as he fouled. Monmouth up by one, but then Robert Morris got running again in the second half. Andre Boyd, the pull-up jumper off the break, putting his team up by three, and Jarrett Durham's Colonials went on to win their 22nd game of the year. The fans streaming onto the court. They now go to the NCAA tournament. Fresno and finding it easy going in the middle. Reggie Jordan cutting in the lane, scoring the layup to put his team up by 16. The Bulldogs then come up with a steal, but Wilbur Hooker tries the slam. He misses. New Mexico State heads the other way on the 3-on-1. Keith Hill to Michael New for the jam, and Fresno simply frustrated. Fresno State, their own worst enemy in this game, really. James Anderson with a steal ahead to Keith Hill for the easy layup. New Mexico State up by 20 at that point, and it was time for the Aggies to cut down the net. As co-champions of the Big West, they're co-champions with UNLV and the Aggies Athletic and Convocation Center. The Irish had lost three straight, but on the break here, Devon Sweet between the legs dribble to Alfonso Ellis. Ellis lays it in, draws the foul. The Irish up by four, and Digger is started. They went on 13-4 run, and then the Irish really almost perfect second half. Tim Singleton, the alley-oop to Monty Williams. Williams wins with court speed to lead Notre Dame, and Digger smiling now as it looks like they're on their way to the NCAAs. Notre Dame clinching its eighth straight season. Clinch to share the title instead today. David Hinton, the bad pass kicked off by Linda DeFries, the one-handed power dance. Connecticut had a two-point lead. It was still close in the first half. The point guard, Nadav Hennefield, getting the ball on the side, puts up the three-pointer. It's good. In the second half, Connecticut up by 11. The Huskies on the break, 5-on-3. Hennefield goes in for the layup. It won't fall, but Rod Sellers right there with the ball. The Huskies build a nine-point lead. Chris Smith getting it up top, drives the lane in, banks it off the glass, 4-2. Connecticut coming away with a convincing win. Hennefield finishing with 18 points. Little working the ball down low to main man Alex Kessler, sinking the fadeaway jumper. Georgia by 8. Latrell Green driving baseline now past Reggie Gallen, gets a reverse layup. He finished with 30 points, and Alex Kessler watched the spin move around Zane Arnold. Kessler finishing with 20 points, also hauled down 15 rebounds. Georgia's first SEC championship, and the coach's wife gets a big hug. How about them Dogs?
33,015. Derek Coleman, Stephen Thompson's last home game at the Arm. Mike Hopkins turns it over. Alonzo Mourning starts the break. Mark Tillman finishes, and Georgetown led by as many as 10 in the first half. Lead cut to 36-33. Derek Coleman on the line. John Thompson goes absolutely berserk. Draws a technical foul. Draws another. Draws another. Three technicals. Waves the crowd on as he's ejected from the game. Coleman is 7 of 8 free throws, 6 of them with the technicals, and then they retain possession. Billy Owens nails a 3, a 10-point turnaround, 45-40 Syracuse at the half. That's Craig Escherich, assistant coach, with the job of trying to lead Georgetown back. And when Stephen Thompson gets the feed from Derek Coleman, it was Syracuse by 7, 67-60. But the Hoyas within 2, Alonzo Mourning, yes, and the foul completes the 3-point play. The Hoyas lead at 79-78, 81-79 Georgetown. Billy Owens driving up court. Now Georgetown has the lead, but with a second to go, Sam Jefferson fouls Billy Owens, a gift for Boeheim and company. And so Georgetown, which thought they had the win, watches Owens nail the two free throws. With a second to go, the last gasp for Georgetown to win it, regulation knocked away. We go to overtime, tied at 81. In overtime, 87-86 Syracuse, 28 seconds to go. Coleman the bounce to Thompson, lays it in the Cuse by 3. One last shot with 5 seconds to go. Morning shot, the air ball, time runs out. In overtime, Syracuse beats Georgetown, 89-86. Afterwards, John Thompson says, listen, Ala Abdel-Navi loses the ball. It falls anyway. You figure this was Duke's day. Great Tar Heel passing, though. Scott Williams taking King Rice's pass, sending it home. The Heels are up by five. More great passing. Jokic ripping down the board. The long pass to Rick Fox. And Carolina leads it 40-37. Duke will tie it. Bobby Hurley to Robert Fricke. The Tar Heels lead it by 1.5 in an excellent game. Fricke the board. And the beautiful wraparound pass to Bill Anderson. Duke backs up by two. The lucky bounces wouldn't go for Duke. Out the knob. No. And Dean Smith says, hey, Carolina, you forgot about us, didn't you? King Rice spins to the hoop. It's gone. Rice had 20. Carolina by one. The freshman, Kevin Lynch. Hanging for the two. Tar Heels up at an 8-point lead. Rick Fox goes baseline. The pretty reverse, and the Heels are running away with it by 12. Robert Fricke playing his last home game. Tell you how it felt. Not good. Carolina kind of overlooked. I mean, is he ever in a good mood? Well, he wasn't when Ramil Robinson took the alley-oop pass and slammed it home for the defending national champ, Gene. Lighten up, Gene. But things get better for the Boilermakers. Look at the passes. And Jimmy Oliver finishes it with the jam. Purdue by two at the half. Hey, this is the greatest life, isn't it, Gene? But not so fast. Robinson. The beat inside. Terry Mills. He had 30. The fight shot. Gene, you enjoying your... No, I didn't think so. Purdue then goes on a 7-0 run. Steven Scheffler, he had the unbelievable percentage of shooting. Of course, he says, when you shoot him more than 3 feet, I got a good shot of going in. 26 points he had. Robinson takes it by himself. The high shot off the glass. We're tied at 70. Oh, man, what am I doing this for? Comes down with one last chance. Tie game. Jimmy Oliver had but six. But those are the biggest two right there. 79-77 Purdue. Beats the defending national champions. They cannot now. Michigan win the Big Ten. Purdue still can. And Gene Cady was all smiles after the game here at the end of the year. A pretty head fake by forward Chris King. And with 6 seconds to go, David Carlisle on the line for Wake with them up by 2 minutes. The free throw, Chris Channing brings it up, the clock winding down. Does it pass it off to Brian Howard in time? And is the clock running out on Valvano as well as his team? We shall see. But Wake Forest wins the game in Raleigh by the count of 93-91. Chris King.